Good morning, children. Welcome to social science class. In today's class, you are going to learn business and industry, second chapter from business studies. Without much delay, let's start the class. In this lesson, you are going to learn the objectives of business, types of trades like home trade, foreign trade, and abroad trade, and its importance, and then types of industries like primary and secondary industries, and along with that, we have cottage and small scale industries and its importance. Business and industry. Business is an important economic activity mainly concerned with production and distribution of goods and services to consumers. A business is an organization or enterprising entity engaged in commercial, industrial, or professional activities. According to Stevenson, business means the regular production or purchase and sale of goods undertaken with an objective of earning profit and acquiring wealth through the satisfaction of human wants. What does it mean? Usually business people keep engaged themselves in either in production or purchase and sale of goods to earn minimum or profit or reasonable profit. With that profit, they'll try to acquire wealth by satisfying human wants. Business has two important objectives, that is economic objective and social objective. Let us learn in detail what are economic objectives of business and social objectives of business. Economic objectives. We are under the impression that earning profit is the main objective of business. It is not like that. The sole objective of business includes earning reasonable profit that is sufficient to enable the business to cover the cost and the businessman to lead a normal, comfortable life. Why do people take businessmen? They are involving in business to earn reasonable profit, and the business is done to cover the expenses what they have done. Along with that, they are also intends to take a minimum profit so that they can lead their life. Business supplies goods and services to consumer and creates consumers. It uses the available resources to produce goods that are sufficient to consumers. It produces such goods that are required from time to time according to changes that take place. It brings changes in production by adopting new technologies. You might have observed all the products will not remain same. It keeps on changing with the quality and also with the quantity and also with the new packing and all. So how do the people will do means? Obviously, by adopting new techniques, they'll try to bring lot of changes in production. And then it promotes the products through advertisement. You have understood the meaning of advertisement in the previous class. So advertisement is nothing but promoting the goods. It promotes the products through advertisement. How you people will come to know about the new products, what is available in the market, means it is only through advertisement. Not only that, even the changed products also displayed in the advertisement. With that, people will come to know what are the products available in the market. So advertisement plays major role in promoting product. So business will promote products, and it also creates consumers and also expands market. These are the economic objectives. Once again, let me remind you, the important objective of business is earning reasonable profit. Business supplies goods and services to consumers and creates consumers. It brings changes in production by adopting new techniques. It promotes the products through advertisement. So let me come to social objectives. Social objectives of business are: business produces goods which are required for the development of nation. They are not going to produce much goods which is anti-social element. Okay, so they'll produce the goods which is in the mode of development of nation. It provides employment and improves the standard of living. So it provides employment in large scale, and with that people can earn salary or wages. After earning salary and wages, obviously the standard of living of people improves. So it helps in a nation in this way. And not only that, it also helps in the economic development of nation by paying rates, tax and duties. You are aware that taxes or duties are revenue for government. After earning these revenues, government tries to implement more and more welfare programs for people. The next important objective is business also contributes a fair share for social welfare of the nation. What all the programs are adopted by the government to improve the standard of people, definitely even business will help in this regard. If I take an example of Infosys and Wipro, they are providing lot of funds to education of rural people, and not only that, they're also helping in providing basic amenities for rural mass. So you know that Infosys and Wipro companies have adopted villages and schools, and they're trying to improve their standards, and they'll provide the basic infrastructures for schools, and they'll provide free uniform and library facilities and computer labs, science labs, etc. They're also providing faculties to teach rural schools. And not only that, they'll also adopt public places like parks and libraries, etc., or grounds. They'll try to maintain it. The maintenance cost will be borne by companies or business people. Okay, children? So with that, they're trying to assist the government in bringing social welfare. So once again, I'll remind you, social objectives: business produces goods which are required for development of nation, and then they produce quality goods, they create employment, they cooperate with the government to eradicate some problems, and not only that, they're also involved in social welfare programs of the government. Now let us come to trade. Trade is divided into three types: home trade, foreign trade, and abroad trade. Home trade has wholesale trade and retail trade. Foreign trade includes import, export, and abroad trade. Let us know all this trade in detail. Home trade. The word itself will say that it is home trade. Here, home refers to nation. The trade within the country is called home trade. It is carried through retailers and wholesalers. Who are these retailers and wholesalers? Let us know. Retail trade. Retailers carry out their trade at the places where consumers live. They buy goods from the wholesalers and sell them to the consumers. They render various services to the consumers. Some of them are, they are the last connecting link in the distribution of goods. You know that producers will not sell the products directly to consumers, and they are dependent on distributors. Among the distributors, you have various people, and retailers also one who plays major role in distributing the goods. So they are the connecting link in distribution of goods, and they store the goods and supply according to the requirement. They provide credit facilities to the consumers and suggest alternative goods. Who are these retailers? Means obviously, in your location, you can find provision shops, and also you can find the shops which sells the goods, and they sell the garments and they sell the shoes, like that. Many shops are there. All these people are called retailers. These retailers buy goods from the wholesalers, and they'll sell it in single or double or multiple quantities. And then they are the connecting link, as I said, the distribution of goods. They will buy goods from wholesalers, and wholesalers buy goods from producers, and after that they'll try to distribute it to people, and they store the goods and supply according to the requirement. You know that every day we don't require all the products what we require, and number also less. We'll go and we'll buy according to our requirement, but these retailers, they will store the goods and supply it according to the need of the people. That's why it is said that they store the goods and supply according to the requirement. They provide credit facilities. Obviously, if you are very familiar with the shopkeeper, they are going to give a credit facility. That means they will give you the goods in well in advance, and they'll collect money later. It may be a weekly based priorities or monthly based. They are going to collect money later, but goods are given in advance. That is what we call it as credit facilities. And then they'll also suggest alternative goods. When you are interested to buy product A, when you go to shop, if the product A is not available, then he will not send you back. He will say that there is an alternative product called B. Please buy that, even it is also equally good like A. And he will try to convince, and after that obviously you will come with the product. And this in this way they'll just try to suggest alternative goods. They are not only suggest the alternative goods, they will also say that what are the new goods available in his shop and what has come in the market. So in this way they'll try to expand the business and expand the market and create more consumers. Let's come to wholesalers. Who are these wholesalers? The wholesalers are the people who buy large quantity goods from the producers, and after buying that they are going to sell it for retailers. They provide credit facilities to retailers. How the retailers provide credit facilities to consumer? In the same way, even retailers get credit facilities with wholesalers. They supply market trends to the retailers. Whatever is available in the market and what is in a more demand, according to that the wholesalers will supply the products to retailers. They do not keep high margin of profit. When it compared to retail business, obviously the wholesalers will not keep much of profit. Their margin of profit is less compared to retailers. The retail trades are two types, that is, one is permanent shops and second one is itinerant or mobile traders. What is permanent shop means? What are the provisional stores and other stores you find near your house? These are called permanent shop. They won't change the location. These shops will remain for a long time. And then next is mobile traders or itinerant shops means these will keep moving from one place to another, otherwise they will settle in one center. And these are simple and they'll come door to door. Under this you have hawkers, peddlers, street vendors and market vendors. So who are hawkers? They carry goods on their heads and move from door to door and sell their goods. They generally sell only one or two types of goods. Example, vegetables and fruits and flower vendors. The next is peddlers. The peddlers, they carry goods on wheeled carts and sell them to the consumers at their stores. They generally sell more than one type of goods. Street vendors, they display goods in busy streets corner or on the pavement and sell them to the consumers. If you go to Malleshwaram, you can see that lot of people sitting on the footpath and selling their products. And they'll try to attract people in many ways. The next important one is market sellers. Weekly markets take place at villages or towns once in a week. Different traders take their goods to these markets and sell them to the consumers. Another specialty of this weekly market is that the surrounding villages bring goods which they grow or produce and sell them. That is what we call it as direct selling. The producer will sell his product directly to consumer. After selling the product what he has brought, he will also take the products what he requires. Example, vegetables, butter, agricultural implements, blankets, like that many products will be brought to the market and they'll try to sell it. And after selling, whatever the products they require, they'll take home. These are the types of retail selling. Next, let us come to the next one, foreign trade. Foreign trade broadly classified into imports, exports and interport trade. What are these? Let us learn. The trade between the two countries is called foreign trade. Foreign trade can be classified into three types. They are imports, exports and interport trade. Imports means referring a country buying goods from other country for its use. That means when the country lacks in some product, otherwise the shortage of products has occurred, then the country will try to import from other country. This is called import trading. Example, India doesn't have much oil sources. That's why what India will do? India imports oil from other countries. The next is export. Export refers to a country selling its goods to other country for their use. When we have excess goods in our country, we will try to export it to other country. With that, we are trying to gain profit. So it is just like a mutual understanding. And the next is interprop trade. Interprop trade is a different trade. Here, the country will not buy the product for its own usage. It will try to buy the products from one country to sell it to other country. This is what we call it as interprop trade. And here also, the countries will earn huge profit. And today, it is expanding. We have Singapore and Middle East countries, for example, for interprop trade. Interprop trade refers to a buying of goods from one country with a view to sell it to other country. Nowadays, many countries are carrying out interprop trade because, as I said, that it is earning huge profit. And what is the need for foreign trade? Do you think there is importance for foreign trade? Obviously, yes. As you know that no country in the world is self-sufficient in all the natural resources. Some countries have plenty of natural resources. Using the available natural resources, they produce more goods than they require, and the excess is exported to other countries. In this way, many countries are trying to help each other. It may be business, but simultaneously, every country is benefited of foreign trade. Next, let us come to industries. Industry is an economic activity. It is concerned with the production of goods, extraction of minerals, and also providing some services. Industries are classified into two main groups. They are primary industries and secondary industries. Let us know what are primary industries. Primary industries produce goods by using the natural resources. Example, agriculture, fishing, dairy farming, mining, etc. These industries are further divided into two. They are genetic industries and extractive industries. Genetic industries are engaged in reproduction of different crops, animals, and plants. They help to increase the wealth of a nation. Example, horticulture, dairy farming, poultry farming. These are categorized under genetic industries. Next, we'll come to extractive industries. Extractive industries are engaged in extracting different raw materials and ores from the earth. It is also called non-renewable industry. Example, extraction of ores. Drilling of oil wells these are the examples for extractive industries. Let us go to secondary industries. Secondary industries, also called as manufacturing industries, and they are labor-oriented industries. They are further divided into manufacturing industries and construction industry. What are manufacturing industries? Manufacturing industries are engaged in converting raw materials or semi-finished products into finished products. They are mainly labor-oriented and supply finished products to consumers. For example, converting iron into steel, sugar out of sugar cane, etc. Construction industries. They are engaged in construction of roads, canals, bridges, etc. These industries help in quick development of economic activities like transport and communication. And after this, let us come to cottage and small scale industries. What are cottage industries? Cottage industries are also called as household industries. They are carried out by craftsmen in their own houses with the help of family members or apprentices. They mainly concentrate in the villages and produce goods mainly for local market. Carpentry, smithy, carpet weaving, pottery, blanket making are the examples for cottage industries. Even these industries play major role in earning profits and also export business. Small scale industries. These are organized in a small scale in a particular place. They use electric power and some machines, simple machines. They employ laborers and adopt modern techniques. Examples are chemical industry and bicycle, fan, radio, sewing machine, soap, garments, etc. These are the examples for small scale industry. Here, the people will manufacture goods for both local and external market. Industries plays vital role in the business and also in the development of nation. Industries earns huge profit. The second largest unit which earns profit to the nation. Okay, children, I hope you have understood the lesson. Before I conclude the lesson, let me recall what we have learned. Today, you have understood the meaning of business and objectives of business, and after that you have learned trade, meaning of trade and types of trade. Under that you have understood home trade and foreign trade, and you have also learned the meaning of intercross trade, and you have understood importance of foreign trade. And then industries are categorized into primary and secondary industries, and after that types of industries under primary industry and secondary industry, and cottage industries, meaning of cottage industries and its importance, small scale industries and its importance. You have few questions to answer in your homework book. What are the economic and social objectives of business? How retail trade is different from wholesale trade? Name the three types of foreign trade. Give two examples for genetic and cottage industries. You have to write answers for these questions in your homework book. Children, please keep engaged yourself in writing homework books regularly. Whatever the homeworks are given, please try to complete it. And if you have any doubts or queries, please try to put your questions in WhatsApp group as usual. So let me conclude today's lesson here itself, and let us meet in the next lesson. I hope you have understood the lesson. Have a nice time. Thank you.